We have two public comment speakers signed up this evening. Our first speaker is Richard Ford.
Good evening. My name is Richard Ward. Commissioners, last Thursday, the Forsyth County News reported that the commission voted unanimously to have our commission chairman and vice chairman meet with the city of Cumming regarding the water contract, and that the meeting will be open to the public. I would like to commend the entire commission on this decision. The majority of our taxpayers and water users, including myself, have little understanding of the complexities of the city and county relationship as supplier and customer of our water. This is a wonderful opportunity to educate us, the general public, as to the complicated negotiations that are involved to make this partnership a win-win situation for both the city of Cumming and Forsyth County. These open meetings should dispel the idea some have had in the past that the city and county water partnership has not been fair to both parties. Once again, thanks to all five commissioners for this decision.
Our next speaker is Sharon Gunter.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. I'm Sharon here. I was delighted to hear last week about the negotiations for the upcoming water contract renewal between the city and the county. City of Cumming and County Forsyth to be held openly and public. I understand that this situation, as we all realize, that the city had the foresight years ago to apply for a permit to withdraw water from Lake Lanier, and the city recently has purchased a very large expensive pump of which the county shares a rather large bill. The city would like a new contract with the county to be for a period of 25 to 50 years. Further, it's my understanding that even if and when the county has their own pumping facility, the city would require the county to purchase the first $3 million per day from the city without a cap on the price per gallon. It is my understanding the city does not have permission to withdraw any more water than the current permit allows and has a pending permit. It is my understanding further that the Corps of Engineers' latest recommendations will not be public until their June report. Any agreement created should have a reasonable term length for the possibility of an extension and then a possible second extension, and certainly a cap for the price in some fashion. We should not make a contract for such an extended period of time without all the information on the table. That just makes good business sense. I have the highest regard and respect for the mayor and the city councilman, but their job as city officials is to look after the interests of the city. As county officials, your job entails making sound, wise agreements that make good judgment, sense, and business, and looking out for the interests of the county and its citizens. I have heard that these negotiations may be difficult at best because the matter is very complex. My most heated arguments are with those that I care for the most and over issues that I care for deeply. That is the scenario between the city and the county. This issue and the internal governmental party that you're both dealing with are dear and near to both of us. We are all neighbors and need to work well on joint concerns, but we, the citizens of this county, need to be assured that the Board of Commissioners is active and not passive on protecting our interests, and that visibility and transparency are always present. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
That was our final speaker, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Do I hear a motion to adopt the minutes for the regular meeting on February 2nd?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote on the motion. That carries unanimously.